Hi, I'm Peter from URender, and in this video I will show you a very easy and fast workaround to achieve nice wireframe renderings. First, load any kind of model you like. I use the puppet model from the content browser that can be found here. I have already posted a bit. Start URender and assign a URender material to the mesh. It doesn't matter if your model contains a single or several mesh parts with a complex hierarchy. Just put everything into a null object. With this null object selected, create an instance object. Now your model is duplicated as an instance. Create an atom array object and parent the instance to it. Now create a material for the wireframe and assign it directly to the atom array object. Depending on the size and mesh density of your model, you have to adjust the cylinder and sphere radius to define the thickness of your wireframe. You also can decrease the subdivisions to 4. Already looking good, but depending on how we define the thickness of the wireframe, there can be a lot of anti-aliasing flickering. To get rid of it, I recommend turning off FXAA and only use multi-frame sampling. A value around 8 is a good value for quality and performance. When you use FXAA together with multi-frame sampling, you will notice that there can occur artifacts on fine details. The great thing about this workaround is that you now have tons of possibilities to adjust your style. You can keep your shading or use the emissive channel to make it more flat looking. Just set a background color in the render settings, and with these few steps, you have made a very appealing presentation of your model. Because I used an instance, I can change the model in any kind of way and the wireframe immediately updates. You also can change the complete model. Just drag the new model into the null object, assign the material, and you are ready. Thanks for watching.